The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. 9th chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 26th of April, 1976, in Melbourne, Australia.
As Krishna said previously, Maya Tadamidam Sarvam, by me, I am spread all over the universe. Everywhere, Krishna is there. By His energy, I have explained this. Now, about this prakriti, material nature, how it is working. This material nature is just like a machine, big machine. The same example, just like this body, my body, your body, it is also a machine, a lump of matter made into machine. Any machine is lump of matter, but it is working. But working how? Working by the touch of somebody's spiritual. Without spiritual touch, matter cannot work. This has to be understood. Same example, your body. It is very wonderful machine. The medical science, when they dissect the body, find so many wonderful arrangements, the nerves, the muscles, they're all matter. But they're so nicely set up that is working very nice. This dictaphone machine, the tape recorder, is working very nicely, set up with so many electronic parts. But after all, it is matter. If there is no worker, it is easy. The machine is wonderful, undoubtedly. But there is a worker, there's a computer, the wonderful machine. The aeroplane, very wonderful machine, flying in the sky. But the pilot is there. Without pilot, it is dangerous. The machine is there, and if the pilot is not in order, then we are in danger. In this way, we have to study that this material world, the adjustment, there are so many planets, sun, moon, stars, and very, very big arrangements. This is also the same process, a big machine. But who is the pilot? Who is the conductor? That is explained here. Mayad bhakshena prakriti swati satarasa. The background manipulator is God, is Krishna. The scientists, physicists, chemists, they are praising, or they are trying to study the machine only, but they have no information of the person who is manipulating the machine. That is a defect. So, in human form, the cats and dogs, they cannot understand that behind the machine there is a person who is manipulating the machine. The cats and dogs, they cannot understand. Just like a child cannot understand how an electric fan is moving. In my childhood, I have several times, I was thinking that within the fan there is a ghost. But I was suggesting, that was intelligence, there must be somebody, otherwise how it is moving. In the gramophone box, I was thinking that there is a man within the box. He is singing. So, these are intelligence. There is one story, there was one drum, and a child was beating, it was sounding very loudly. So, he wanted to see who is the person within the drum that is vibrating. So, with a knife he cut it. So, these are things, research work. it may be childish proclivities, but the tendency to find out who is the ultimate cause of everything, that is intelligence. That is called darshan. In Sanskrit, it is called darshan shastra, or philosophy, to find out the ultimate source. So in the Vedanta Sutra, that celebrated philosophy, Indian philosophy, Vedanta Sutra, the beginning of Vedanta Sutra is Athato Brahma Jigyasa, Brahma Jigyasa. Now, this human form of life is meant for inquiring about the ultimate truth. In the lower animal forms, our inquiry is, where is food, where is shelter, where is sex, and where is defense? Ahara nidra bhaya maithuna. To eat something, and to sleep somewhere, and to have some sex enjoyment, and some defense force, I may feel that I am secure. There is good government, there is good police arrangement, I can sleep very nicely. So these four things, ahara nidra bhaya maithuna. Ahara means eating, nidra means sleeping, and bhaya, to take protection from insecurity, and maithuna, sex life. Samanam etat pasubhina nana. These things are bodily necessities equally applicable to the lower animals and the human being. Then what is the extra engagement that a human being is superior than the animal? What is that extra quality? Otherwise, what is the difference between a human being and a dog? The dog is after eating, sleeping, mating, and defense. And as soon as another dog comes in the vicinity, the dog thinks the another dog has come. He begins to bark. Why you have come here? Get out. So, if we simply engage ourselves, civilization, for simply economic development, means ahara nidra, bhaya, and sex pleasure, then where is the difference between the dog's life and the human life? There is no difference. The Vedic civilization does not make any difference between a dog's life and a human being's life, unless in the human form of life there is inquiry about the absolute truth. Athato Brahma Jigyasa. This is the beginning of philosophy. Now you have got this human form of life, advanced intelligence, advanced consciousness. Now it is your duty to inquire about the absolute truth. Because in the beginning of the chapter we have studied the asaddhana purusha dharma shasa parantapa mang apraapya nivartanti mittu samsara sa bhatmati. There is no school, college and institution to make research what is mittu samsara bhatmati. We are so fallen that we do not inquire, just like the same animal. The animal is being taken to the slaughterhouse, everyone knows. But the animal has no capacity to inquire why I am being taken to this slaughterhouse. He has no capacity. He has no capacity to make any counteraction against that being taken to this slaughterhouse. Mittu samsara bhakti. Every one of us, we are going to the slaughterhouse. But the human being, if he is by force, he is taken to this slaughterhouse, he'll at least make some protest, cry, that why this man is taking me to this slaughterhouse. But the animal has no although he sees, he cries. There are tears in the eyes sometimes you have seen. They know that we are being taken to the slaughterhouse without any fault. We are doing no harm. Just like the cows, they are eating grass and in exchange giving you the most nutritious food, milk. But we are so cruel and so ungrateful that we are taking the cows to the slaughterhouse. The cow, according to Vedic civilization, is considered mother. Why not mother? She is supplying milk. Why mother is respectful? Why you offer our respect to mother? Because when you are helpless, we cannot eat anything, the mother supplies milk from the breast. Mother means who supplies the food. So if the cow is supplying food, milk, milk is so nutritious and full of vitamin, and she is our mother. In the Shastra, there are seven mothers, according to Vedic civilization, seven mothers. One mother is real mother, from whose womb we have taken birth, Adho Mata. This is the real mother. Guru Patni, the wife of spiritual master or teacher, she is mother. Adho Mata Guru Patni Brahmani, the wife of a Brahmana, she is also mother. Actually, a civilized man sees all women except his own wife as mother. Not seven, eight, everyone. Mātrivat paradāreṣu, paradarbheṣu loṣṭhava. A learned scholar does not mean how many degrees he has got. A learned person means who sees all women as mother. So apart from all women, at least seven we should accept as mother. Adho Mata Guru Patni Brahmani. Brahmani Rajapatnika, the queen. The queen is mother. Rajapatnika. Venu, cow. Cow is mother. And Dhatri, nurse. She is mother. Venu Dhatri. Tathapriti. And the earth. She is giving us so many varieties of food. So, this is philosophy. So, we should be very much kind, at least to the cows. If one is addicted to meat eating, he can kill some other minor animals like goats, sheep, hogs, pigs. There are other animals. But in the Bhagavad Gita, especially, it has been mentioned, krishi goraksha vanijyam vaishyakarma sabhavaj. Goraksha. That is a very important thing in the society, to give protection to the cows and to get milk. And varieties of milk preparation, ultimately ghee, is very important thing. In India, every home requires sufficient quantity of ghee, but they are not meat eaters. The meat eaters cannot tolerate ghee. There is a saying that a dog cannot digest ghee. Kukurat pate ghee hajam. So, the subject matter is that to understand the philosophy. So, athāta brahma jignāsa, in order to be inquisitive to the ultimate truth, what is the ultimate truth, we require a certain type of brain. Not ordinary men, they are inquisitive. The lower grade of brains, like the animals, they cannot inquire. That is not possible. Therefore, in the Vedanta Sutra, it is said that athāta brahma jignāsa, athā, because you have got this human form of body, now you inquire. What is the goal of life? What is the absolute truth? What is your relationship with the absolute truth? And how you should work, what is the aim of life. This is philosophy. That is possible. in the human form of life, Athata Brahma Jigyasa, and the reply, the philosophy of Vedanta Sutra. Sutra means shortcut, codes. The basic knowledge is summarized in some code word. So, the purpose of Ved is to understand, is to search out Krishna. Vedaishta sarvai ahameva vedam. The purpose of Vedic knowledge is to search out the absolute truth, God or Krishna. That is human being's business, actual occupation. So here, the absolute truth personally presents himself and he says, Mayadhaksena prakriti suyati satya. You have to make research, philosophical. That is the business of human form of life. Now, directly see, I am present here. Mayadhaksena prakriti suyati. I am the controller of this universe. In the next part, as it is said, Abhajananti Manamurha. As soon as Krishna says that I am the person who is conducting the whole universal affair, but those who are Murha, Murha means asses, no intelligence, Murha. The ass is the animal which is taken as the Murha, no intelligence. Why? Because the ass carries tons of load on his back. And especially in India, the washermen, they keep ass carrying the loads of cloth. And he's given a little morsel of grass. And he stands there always at the door of the washerman. Just on his order, he has to carry tons of loads. Not a single cloth belongs to him, but he carries, and what is the exchange? A little grass. But this animal, this foolish animal, cannot understand that I can get grass anywhere. Why I am standing here to carry the loads of yours? Therefore it is ass. Ass means he has no intelligence. That simply for little grass in exchange, I'm engaged to work whole day and night. So the karmis means the fruitive actors, workers. Practically you will find every one of us, they are working so hard day and night, going here from the early in the morning, 4 o'clock. But what they are eating? Say 2 chapatis, that's all, or 3 chapatis. So he has no sense for 2 chapatis or 3 chapatis, why I am working so hard? That is ass. He has no question. He is working day and night. Don't take this ass only as the so-called hard worker. He is also working like an ass in exchange. I have seen one big businessman in New York. He was eating only, drinking a little tea and a matzah toast. That's all, whole day. But he is busy, always working very, very hard. But the kormis are considered as ass. But the grass is already there. The ass cannot see. Therefore, Shastra says, Narmuni says, that why you are so busy about your economic development? That is already ordered. You cannot get more than what you are destined to get. Neither you can get less. You will get it. The saivahita prajatita kovila. The human life is meant for not making arrangement what I shall eat, where I shall sleep. That is already arranged. The human life is meant for, as the Vedanta Sutra says, athata brahma jigyasa. But because you do not know the Vedic Shastra, therefore, we unnecessarily try to make economic development. There are so many hundreds and thousands of men, they are very working hard. But does it mean that everyone is becoming millionaire? No. That is not possible. Even though you work very, very hard, whatever you are destined to get, you get. A child born in a rich family with his birth, he's millionaire. And another person, throughout the whole life, he has worked very hard. Hardly he has gotten his 2 times food. Why? There is the cause. Mayadhasena prakriti is earthy, etc. Whatever you are destined, the management is in the hands of the Supreme. So you cannot get more, you cannot get less. It is already destined. This belief, unless one is firmly believer in the existence of the Supreme Person, God, one cannot believe it. He thinks that I shall improve my position. That is not possible. When I first came to America, I thought that America is so rich, there is no poor man. But when I actually went there, I saw that there are so many persons lying on the street. Why? The country is rich, they have got resources, everything, but why? Some men are lying on the street and some men are very happy in otherwise. So destination, destined, order, things are there. That is the Vedic instruction, we get information. Kikaja bahunam vidudhati kama. Everything we'll get according to his karma, destiny. The human life is only for inquiring about the aim of life, the sufferings of life, the absolute person who is managing the whole affair. These inquiries should be there. Jivasya tattva jigyasa, jivasya, the human being, must inquire about these things. That is human life. In many places they have been explained in different way. Nayang deho deho bhajang niloki kastana kamad arhatibir bhujangi. This human form of life is not meant for working so hard like the pigs whole day and night. They are searching after food. This is not human life. Human life must be very sober and must inquire about the absolute truth. That is called Brahminical civilization. Brahminical civilization means the whole human society is divided into 4 classes. The first class, intelligent class, they are called Brahmana. And the second class, they are the politicians or the government men, Kshatriyas. And the third class, the productive class, Vaishyas. And the fourth class, the worker, general worker. And less than that, Panchamas. They are called Chandalas. Chatudvarnam maya sistam guna karma vibhagas. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. The human society must be divided into 4 divisions. Then it will be perfect. Just like in your body, there are 4 divisions. The brain division, the arm division, the belly division, and the leg division. That is perfect body. If all these 4 departments are in order, brain is in order, arms is in order, and the belly is in order, and the legs are in order, then you are healthy. You require all these things. You require brain. Otherwise, how will you conduct your business? So there must be a first class man, very intelligent class man, who will guide the social activities. And the army or arm, then the Kshatriya government must be very strong. Just like when somebody is coming to attack you, naturally your arm first of all try to protect you. They are called armies, Pramadu. And the Kshatriyas, the government must be there. Look to the security of the whole population. And the Vaishyas, the productive class, mercantile class, traders, they must see to the food supply of the whole human society. That everything is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Therefore you are simply insisting that the human society, if you take the instruction from the Bhagavad Gita, then the human life becomes perfect. Otherwise, without any guide, without any instruction from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, if we make our so many plans, it will not be perfect, and ultimately it will fail. And they say, the modern politicians, especially the communists, that we require
revolution
for change now. But if you have right guide, there is no need of change. It will go on very nicely. So here it is said that in nature you can see the working of the nature, how it is nicely working. Just at 6:30, immediately the sun rises. Immediately light. The whole night was dark. And 6:30 in the morning, immediately the sun rises, there is light. Then after giving you light whole day, then in the evening, again the sun is set. The moon is coming to give you light. In this way, you see how nicely arranged the nature is working. And do you think there is no brain behind it? This is foolishness. Without brain, without good manager, how these things have been managed so nicely, seasonal changes, we require temperature, so the sun from 93 million miles away giving us temperature, say everything so nicely arranged, and you think that there is no management, there is no brain. This is foolishness. We can see in our everyday life that without nice management, things cannot go so nicely and properly. So why don't you think? So if you cannot think, because we are all asses, therefore Krishna comes and says that here I am the person. Maya dhakshina prakriti shriyati sacharasaram. So prakriti, this material nature, is dealing with two kinds of things, chor and achor. Chor means moving the animals, the living entities. And achar, achar means standing, just like dead matter. So the dead matter is also being managed by the Supreme Brain, and the living entities, they are also being managed by the Supreme Being. Maya dhakshina prakriti suyate sacharasanam. On account of my presence, hetuna anena, on account of this reason, Kauntya, my dear Arjuna, jagat vi parivartate. The whole world is jagat. Jagat means progressing, going on. The worldly affairs going on. Jagat vi parivartate. But unfortunately, as Krishna says in the next verse, avajananti mamamurha. Those who are asses, no brain. Avajananti. Avajananti means delight. Doesn't care that here is Krishna, the original, supreme Lord, conducting everything. So they cannot understand. Avajananti maga murha. Therefore we should not remain a murha, asses. We must be intelligent animal. Or we must become brahmana. Brahmana, then manusalam salse sukaschin jatati siddhaya. Out of many millions of men, one may be very eager to make his life perfect. Manusaram sahasri. Jatatam api siddhyanam kaschid vetrimam tattat. And out of many such perfect person, hardly or maybe one understand what is the Supreme Lord, Krishna. Therefore, Krishna comes personally to teach us. Because he is very much affectionate. We are all sons of Krishna. We have no other father, the Supreme Father. He is the Supreme Father. He is very much affectionate. And because we are part and parcel of Krishna, mamai manasa jiva bhuta, all these living entities, they are my part and parcel. Without any discrimination. The human being, or the animals, or the plants, trees, aquatics, every one of us a living being, and we have got different dress only, according to our karma. Just like here we are sitting, hundreds of men, and we have got different dress. Similarly, every living being, is part and parcel of Krishna. You cannot mistreat other lower animals, then Krishna will be displeased. Suppose your father has got 5 sons, and one of them or 2 of them are useless. And if the useful son proposes to the father that, "Father, this son is useless, so why not kill him?" So will the father be pleased and give order? No, he cannot kill. He should be taken more care. This is power. Similarly, every living entity, the aquatics, the birds, the beasts, the insects, the plants, the trees, the animals, and the human beings, civilized and civilized, everyone is Krishna's son. That is described. Sarvajoni shukantiya sambhavanti murtayaja tasana mahajani brahma ahanga bija padapita. I am the seed-giving father, and the mother is material nature. So these things have to be understood. And the Supreme Person is giving lesson, instruction personally. So why should we miss this opportunity in this human form of life? That is not very good intelligence. It is so simple. Krishna consciousness movement is very, very simple. You can see practically where is the difficulty. You worship the deity, and you take prasadam, and you chant, and you dance, and you become realized. It has been already described in the beginning. Sushukham kottum abhayam. You execute Krishna consciousness is very, very pleasing. There is no difficulty. Kottum abhayam. And whatever little you do, that is permanent assessment. It will never be lost. So, don't neglect, don't become murhas, as it is said here, abhajananti mana mura, manusim tanumasitam. Because Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, comes here with compassion for us, just like human being. He is not human being, not like us, and he has got immense power. If you study Krishna's life from the very beginning of his birth, he's God. When he was only 3 months old, the Putana Rakshasi came to kill him, but she was killed by the 3 months old child. So he had to kill so many demons, he had to act so wonderfully that he has proved that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But because we are not intelligent, therefore we take him as ordinary human being. Avajananti manga murha. By taking Krishna as ordinary human being, we become murha. No. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Radi Govinda, Sarvakarana Karana, Sarvakarana Karana, original cause. So, why they are neglecting Avajananti manga murha manasim tanuvasana? Therefore, we have to prepare our eyes to see Krishna. Otherwise, if we keep ourselves as ass, even Krishna is present before us, we cannot see. Param bhava bhajananta mama bhuta maheshwaram. So, param bhava, the absolute secrecy, how to understand Krishna, that is explained in this Bhagavad Gita. If we study carefully, we have tried to explain. People are appreciating all over the world about this book. So I wish that in Australia also, you ladies and gentlemen, you take advantage of this moment, you study this Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and other literatures to understand Krishna. And if you understand Krishna, janma karma chami divam ju janati tattva, in truth, then your life is successful. What is that success? Takta deham punar janma naiva. The success means human form of life. Success means to stop this birth, death, old age and disease. That is success. Not that if you can construct a skyscraper building or a very big motor car, that is success. No, that is not success. Because we are under the prakriti krimanani. We are under the classes of prakriti. Prakriti is giving us according to our association. Karanam guna sangharsa. We are getting a different type of body. In this life, I may be fortunate to construct a very big building, but next life, if I am going to become a dog or cat, then what is the success? That is not success. Success is to understand the whole philosophy and stop the process of birth, death, old age and disease. That is success. That you can do only simply by understanding Krishna. Janma karma chami dibbam jujanati tattata takta deham punarjanmanati. This is one. This is actually the business of human life. Athato brahma jigyasa janmardasya jata. This is the philosophy of life. So our request is you try to understand this philosophy, this movement, take advantage and spread it, be happy and make others happy. Thank you. Outside, what do you mean outside?
Outside, outside of the system. He means living out independently and also...
Oh yes, why not? Yeah. It is simply an example how to become Krishna conscious. You can start a similar place in your home, in your village, in your town. You can do that. It is simply an example how to conduct Krishna consciousness business. It is not that the business is limited. It is not limited. Therefore we have written so many books. It is a great science. You can do it anywhere. And that is the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He said, Prithivite ache jato nagara rigra. All over the world, as many towns and villages are there, this Krishna consciousness movement must be spread. So one must know the science and spread it. That is wanted. People are suffering for want of knowledge. They should enlighten by this Krishna consciousness movement. That is the business of human life. Especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered the Indians to do it. He said, Bharat bhumite manusya janma haila ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. His mission is that anyone who has taken birth in India, he first of all make his life successful and spread this knowledge for welfare activities of the whole human society. This is required. Maya. So this Maya can be avoided. The method is very simple. Māmi vaja pravardante māyā me tāṁ taraṁ. So if we actually want to get relief from the Maya, that is Krishna's program. He says ultimately that sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam bhaja. If we actually do that, māmekam saraṇam bhaja, surrender to Krishna, then it is very easy to get out of the clutches of māyā instantly. He says, as yours, aham kvā sarva-pāpebhya moksha. Māyā is police custody. If one is criminal, then police is dangerous for that person. But if one is honest, the police may remain there. The police has no business with the honest man. Similarly, if we remain honest, then Maya has nothing to do with us. Maya may be there. Same example. Police has nothing to do with the honest, law-abiding citizen. But as soon as one is criminal, he comes under the custody of police, automatically. In this connection there is a Bengali verse, Krishna bhuliya jeev bhoga vancha kore, pasete mayatare japotiya dhare. As soon as we forget Krishna and think myself, I am the enjoyer, I am the king of all I survey, there is maya. That is maya. Everyone is thinking like that, that I am the king of everything, at least I am trying. This endeavor is my activities. But as soon as we come to the understanding, Ishavasamidam Sarvam, everything belongs to Krishna. Krishna also says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram Jagratamasam Sarvalokamaheshwaram Suridam Sarvabhutana Gyatramam Shantit. Simply, we have to understand, at the present moment, materialistic life means every one of us thinking, I am the proprietor. Either individually or collectively, nationally, that is the disease. Everyone is thinking, this land belongs to me. This land belongs to my family. This land belongs to my state, to my nation. But actually this land belongs to Krishna. That is a fact. So this misconception of life means Maya. And as soon as we understand that anything belongs to the Supreme Lord, then whole problem solved. There is United Nations. They are meeting for the last 30 or 40 years. But there is no solution. Because the different nations they are meeting, America is our, Australia is our, India is our, so all these our persons they are meeting and talking. But that is Maya. If they pass a resolution that this whole earthly planet belongs to Krishna, God, so everything is solved immediately. But that we shall not do. That is daivijyesagunamai mahumaya durutya. That conviction, false conviction, is so strong. But as soon as we turn this plate in this way, that everything belongs to Krishna, then the whole solution is there. So it is not very easy to think like that, daivijyesagunamai mahumaya durutya. But at least we shall begin learning. And that is Krishna consciousness movement. At least we shall begin to think like that. And that is possible as recommended by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because the real mistake is within the heart. Falsely I am thinking, I am the proprietor, I am the master, I am the enjoyer. Falsely. This has to be cleansed. Chetadatmanamadhanam. Actually, if we are sober, if you are actually a philosopher, we can very easily understand that why I am claiming this is mine, this is mine. I am a newcomer. I stay here for a few days or for years. So how it becomes a, before my birth land was there and after my death the land will be there. That how the land becomes mine? This simple question, if it is answered, and there is solution of so many problems. So therefore this human form of life is meant for discussing, considering this question. That is called Athata Brahma Jigyasa. So this Krishna consciousness movement is Brahma Jigyasa and the answer. We have published so many books, only these two, question and answer. That's all. So let us begin. It is not a fanatical movement, it is a scientific movement. So our request is that you study this Krishna consciousness movement very soberly, philosophically, and every one of you will be benefited. Thank you very much.